Matrices. How do you represent a matrix? A rectangular arrangement of numbers, symbols, and expressions, arranged in rows and columns. But, how it came into the picture, and for what purpose? The term matrix was first introduced in 1850. But, the concept was first framed during 300 BC, in a Chinese book, named, Nine Chapters of Mathematical Arts, for solving simultaneous equations or solutions. For example, take the price of bread. In this, price could be determined by supply against demand. But, how the price would get affected? By means of grain, economic conditions, and different locations. This can be taken further, by means of weather, and demand for other products in the market. When you are so particular in pricing, and for producing the grain, you would use a tractor. In that case, any changes in oil price would affect the price of bread. So, if you want to measure the changes happening in what-if situations, you need dimensions for each factors. In addition to real-time situations, the matrices has been applied in various branches of science. Regarding physics, it is applied in the study of quantum mechanics, nothing but quantum computing. And in electrical circuits, it is used for manipulating loop current analysis by Gaussian elimination method. While in computer-based applications, matrix plays a vital role in the projection of three-dimensional image into a two-dimensional screen. In geology, it's been used for taking the seismic survey, the form of a geophysical survey, which aims at measuring the Earth's properties by means of physical principles. Other applications includes computer game graphics for representing the color intensity, as well as object's location at a certain point. And in robotics and automation sector, it is used for controlling the movement of robots.